from Norway. We're in the Northern Lights Hall at Hamar, where the Olympic spotlight is about to shine on the first figure skating medal decider of the Games, the pairs.
And Liz, tonight, truly, you are going to learn how a judge's mind works.
I will be the first, Ken.
Yes, you will. And Australia's Danielle and Stephen Carr find themselves in 10th place after their technical program the night before last. If they can maintain that position in tonight's free skate, it'll be a fine effort from the pair who finished 13th in this event at the last Olympics in France.
So sit back and enjoy as Australia takes centre stage.
On the ice representing Australia, Danielle Carr and Stephen Carr.
The Australian champions, Danielle and her brother Stephen Carr, in the 1992 Winter Olympics. They were 13th, gone up in the world, 11th last year, and now, after the technical program, they're lying 10th. Death spiral and still going. Well, that's quite different. Never seen that before. Salco, and it came off well. Double loop, managed to hold on to it, and into a death spiral again. That's a very neat combination of spins. Double salto, double toe loop at the end. Her timing is good. As are those overhead lifts.
Mm-hmm.
and a fairly unique finish as well. Well, Danielle and Stephen, I don't think I've seen them skate as well as that before in a World Championship or an Olympic Games. Very smooth indeed. Their timing was very good. They moved through it all, and that death spiral, of course, was quite unique. Just something we have never seen before. As some of the other things that they did, rather like the finish. So that was good by the Australians.
Well, originality from start to finish. Certainly the best that they've done. Nice balletic style, times. Death spiral, look at that, change of the edge. Beautifully done, and it continued from there. Really a wonderful start to the program. All the jumps came off. Landed together, the axle. Anybody who's been following them would know that they've been showing marked improvement, a couple of top 10 results in the pre-Olympic competition here and in Skate Canada. They were in fact 7th and 5th respectively. 14 times national champions in Australia. And without question, their best, as Anna Week said, their best performance at world level. With a very good technical program to the music of Bob Teufel, the skater's waltz. And now in the free program, let's see how the judges feel about it. 5-1 from Germany, 4-7 from Ukraine, and the crowd feel that they're worthy of better. Australian judge, I recall, Mr. Donald McKnight gives 4.8. Five from the United States and Canada, five ladies and four gentlemen among the judges. Artistic impression. And again, 5-3 from Germany is the high point. One or two of the four seem a little bit hard, but it's a battle of whether they're going to stay in the top 10. One or two variations among the judges. The judge from Belarus here has them down in fifth place. But the Canadian judge thinks they're the pick, and so does the German judge, and so does a couple of others think that they're second at the moment. See if they hold on to 10th place.
Indeed, a splendid effort from Danielle and Stephen. 13th at the last Olympics, that performance tonight should ensure them a slightly better final placing here in Norway.